we just got to our workshop. We are starting a new project. We are going to be building a new letterboard for above our front desk.
We always kind of thought we would buy one, but we came up with the design today. We're gonna go ahead and try to make one ourselves. Since we've got all this downtime with coronavirus, we're gonna go ahead and bust out some more projects. All right, so we are going to be using each of these 1x2x8s, and we are actually gonna be throwing a channel in there, a dado to hold the letters. This way it'll be easy to put announcements or greetings up on that letterboard anytime we want. So I'm gonna go ahead and start by throwing some dados in these 1x2s, and then we'll move on to cutting the letters. All right, I'm gonna cut a test piece and see what this looks like. All right, so my plan is to go ahead and throw a little bit of a dado in like that. Initially, I was gonna slant it for those letters to kind of sit in better, but I don't think I really need to because they're gonna be leaning against the wall anyway. I'm just gonna go ahead and make that first pass, then I'll scooch the fence over and make a second pass to make that a little bit wider. All right, so we just finished our first pass on all these boards doing the first dado. We're gonna go ahead and shift that fence over just a little bit on the table saw and widen that gap. All right, so we're done cutting all of the tracks for the letters, and we just need to go ahead and get those stained, but we also got all this wood cut, all this hardboard that we were gonna actually use to make the actual letters. And with all these pieces, we should be able to get about 96 letters. We just need to go ahead and take this over to the store because the miter saw is over there. We'll get these chopped up. I don't have a crosscut sled for the table saw. We'll get these painted and we'll get the rails all stained. And then we'll move on to the next part of the project, which is hopefully attaching it.
The area where we're building the letterboard is very dark. It is the furthest back corner of our store. We actually used to have marquee lights in that area just to help shed a little bit more light in that corner. We decided when we were at the store today that we were going to build our own light fixture. So Brad designed a gooseneck style light fixture just out of gas pipe. The reason we're doing a gooseneck style light is so that the light comes off the wall and kind of loops back to shine directly on that letterboard.
Thank you.
So we printed out the letters on regular printer paper, and we were going to use Mod Podge to basically glue them down onto the blocks, which is why we painted them white first, just in case there was some transparency, but we didn't have enough. So we ended up going with Craft Bond by Elmer's. You basically shake it up, spray it on, and it's like a sticky glue. So we didn't need to paint them, but I'm so glad we did, just so that the edges and everything are even and consistent with the paper.
I'm getting these tracks for the letters attached to the wall. As you can see, I'm just using these L brackets. I'm attaching them like this because they're a little bit less noticeable from underneath. Otherwise, you would see the entire L bracket. And you can see that the letters just kind of sit in this groove, no problem. You can slide them around. That's kind of how they're gonna sit. I'm just gonna continue getting these rails attached, and I've got one more to put up here, and then we'll go with the lights up top. Loving the way that this letterboard is looking. It's really making that back wall look a little bit more complete. Up above that front counter was a little awkward before, so this is gonna be a nice change. Well, that should be about it for the rails. You can see we left a little bit of space up above for the light fixtures. We gotta paint those. I think they're about dry now, so let's go ahead and get those assembled. So unfortunately, the way these lights are made, they're a little bit big and they kind of actually block this top row. So I think that we're gonna have to take that top row down, unfortunately. And because these cages below are a little bit too high, we're not gonna be able to really fit one below. So I think we're just gonna go with the two rows right now, and we'll save the other row in case we wanna work it in the future. I think this is actually gonna shine pretty nice onto those bottom rows though. So this should work out. A lot cheaper than buying lights from the store, that's for sure. All right, once these lights are all secured, I'm gonna go ahead and make sure that these cords are all nice and tidy along the side, and we'll drop them down the corner. But for now, I'm gonna go ahead and plug one in just to kind of see what this looks like. Yeah, I'm hoping
hoping it doesn't look like too much like focus just on that one spot. Maybe some lower watt bulbs might be a little bit nicer, but it definitely, like, you can really see how dark the top of that wall is now that there's a light there.
It makes it feel like there's no other lights on in this back corner.
I think this bulb is too bright. Maybe we'll go with
so dark over here all of a sudden.
Maybe we'll try a different bulb real quick. Not perfect, but that's okay. It'll hold it for now. Once the other one's up, I think it'll look nicer. I'll have more of a spread. Mm.
In total, this product only cost us about $13 to complete. We bought the wood and the spray adhesive glue, and we were able to reuse stain and paint that we already had. The lights in total cost about $50 for us to build, not including the bulbs. We did see some in stores that were about $70 to $100 a piece, so we thought that this was a nice alternative. This is a pretty easy project for anyone with a really basic set of tools. It would look great inside your house, in your kitchen, or in your store. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. You can also find us on Facebook and Instagram at West Bay Handmade.